That's a single-celled paramecia, one of a multitude of skilled hunter warriors that roam the dewdrop. But they too are hunted. A dileptus, the paramecium's mortal enemy. Paramecium might get lucky and score a direct hit. Even if it doesn't, the recoil from the barrage will put some distance between the paramecium and its attacker. What can I say? That's life in the dewdrop. That little guy is a tardigrade. An animal smaller than the head of a pin. Don't underestimate them. Tardigrades have been living on this planet a lot longer than we have. About 500 million years. For every one of us, there's at least a billion of them. They can make a living anywhere on Earth. In the frigid peaks of the tallest mountains, in the cauldrons of erupting volcanoes, and in the deep ocean vents in the bottom of the sea. Tardigrades are so tough, they can survive naked in the vacuum of space. They've survived all five of the most recent mass extinctions on this planet. A visitor from another world could be forgiven for thinking of Earth as the planet of the tardigrades. We're ever gonna get to the bottom of this dewdrop? Better get a move on. Every leaf and tiny clump of moss has hundreds of thousands of microscopic mouths called stomata. Plants breathe through them, taking in carbon dioxide, exhaling the oxygen that we need to live. The plants can survive without us, but we and all the other animals, we'd be toast without them. The plants make food out of sunlight. We animals can't do that.